Hello students, today we are going to learn the next topic in chapter 5, the various factors controlling the water bearing capacity of the rocks. What do you mean by bearing capacity? It is nothing but the maximum stress or pressure that a footing can sustain without any failure of the soil or the rock which is supporting that footing. Also, bearing capacity is the function of the shear strength of the soil, material or the rock mass. But it also depends upon the size and shape of the footing and also the thickness of the soil or the rock which is adjacent to and above the base of the footing. You have to understand this. Let me repeat. Bearing capacity is the function of the shear strength of the soil material, or rock mass, But it also depends on the size and shape. Coming to the various factors which will control the water bearing capacity. Here, the bearing capacity will greatly influence by many factors, such as soil strength, foundation width and depth, the weight of the soil and surcharge, and also the spacing between the foundations. These factors are related to the loads which are exerted on the soil and considerably affect the bearing capacity. Okay. What is the first one? The first one is the soil strength. What do you mean by soil strength? Bearing capacity of the cohesionless soil, also the mixed soil, will greatly increase unproportionally with increase in its effective frictional angle, because they are directly proportional with the frictional angle. However, this bearing capacity of cohesive soils varies linearly with the soil cohesion, which is provided that the effective friction angle is zero. This is a point you have to remember. What is that? However, bearing capacity of cohesive soils. Cohesive soils varies linearly, okay? When the soil cohesion provided that the effective friction angle is zero. This is a point you have to understand. This is the soil strength test which is normally done. Coming to the next criteria, that is the foundation width. Here, foundation width will greatly affect the bearing capacity of the cohesionless soil. Here, what happens is the bearing capacity of the footing is generally placed at the surface of cohesionless soil. Here, the shear strength of the soil is dependent mainly upon the internal friction, and which is very much proportional to the width of the foundation. Here, the bearing capacity of cohesive soils at constant shear strength and infinite depth is independent of the foundation width. These are the conditions. Okay. Coming to the third one, that is foundation depth. Here, the greater the bearing capacity, the deeper the foundation. Okay, they are directly proportional. This is specifically obvious also in the case of uniform cohesionless soils. But what happens is, in contrary, if the foundation is carried down where a weak soil layer is seen, then what happens? Here the bearing capacity is declined. We have to also understand that the foundations which are placed at depths where the structural weight is equal to the weight of displaced soil, here the adequate bearing capacity will apart from the case where the structure supported by under consolidated soil is subjected to the wetting. Okay, these two points you have to keep it in the mind. Coming to the next thing, that is soil weight and surcharge. What do you mean by soil weight and surcharge? Here the contribution of the subsurface and the surcharge soil, which are influenced mainly by the water table, to the bearing capacity, which cannot be ignored like that. So what happens is that the water table should not be above the base of the foundation to avoid the construction, seepage and uplift problems. If the water table is above the base, these are the problems which you will face. If the water table is below the depth of the failure surface, then it has no influence on the bearing capacity. This is a point you have to remember. Let me repeat. If the water table is below the depth, is below the depth of the failure surface, then it has no influence on the bearing capacity. Okay, on the bearing capacity, it does not have any influence if the water table is below the depth of the failure surface. Coming to the next thing, that is spacing between the foundations. Always remember, it is recommended to consider the minimum spacing between the footing, that is 1.5 times the width of the foundation during the design of the foundation in order to avoid some reduction in the bearing capacity. This is a standard measure. Coming to the next thing, that is earthquake and dynamic motion. What do you mean by dynamic motion? Repeated motions could increase the pore pressure, where the soil and consequently the bearing capacity is decreased, where in the foundation soil. Due to this, the bearing capacity will get decreased. The sources of cyclic movements are earthquakes, vibrating machinery and other sources like vehicular traffic, blasting and pile driving. These are should be avoided. Okay, we should take care to avoid these cyclic movements. Frost action. What do you mean by frost action? Here the frost heave in the certain soils will contract with water and they are subject to the freezing temperatures. Here there will be a reduction in the strength of the frozen soil upon the thawing, which can alter the bearing capacity over the period of time. But low cohesion materials containing a high percentage of silt sized particles are mostly susceptible to the frost action. Okay, silt sized particles are more affected to the frost action. Coming to the subsurface voids. What happened to the subsurface voids? Here the bearing capacity of soil will decrease because the subsurface voids, which are within the critical depth, which are beneath the earth surface, here it is shown, see, this will reduce the strength. Okay, it will decrease the strength. The critical depth is that depth below which the influence of pressure in the soil from the foundation is negligible. What is the critical depth? Let me repeat. The critical depth is that depth below which the influence of pressure in the soil from the foundation is negligible. In the soil from the foundation is negligible. Okay, this is called the critical depth. Coming to the expansive and colloidal soils, what do you mean by those soils? Here how it affects. They have large strength and bearing capacity when they are fairly dry, but the volume of these soils changes due to the changes in the water content. Coming to the potential heave, the potential heave can also be determined from the results of consolidometer test, which is performed in according with the ASTM D 4546. These results are considered in determining preparation of foundation soils, mainly to reduce the destructive differential movements. Okay, this is what we do. Coming to the soil reinforcement. Here the bearing capacity of the soft or weak soil is increased greatly by installing various forms of reinforcements. Means it will help to increase the strength, like metal ties, strips or grids, geotextile fabrics or granular materials. These are the modern techniques which we are using to increase the bearing capacity of the soil which is soft or weak. Coming to the soil erosion and seepage. Here the erosion of soil is around and also it is found under the foundations, where the seepage can also reduce the bearing capacity and also it will lead to the failure of the foundation. Okay, it will generally lead to the failure of the foundation. Hence we have to take care to arrest the soil erosion and seepage. Thank you.